السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أحب أرحب بكم. أول شيء أقول لكم عيدكم مبارك، كل عام وأنتم بخير. هذه محاضرتنا حتكون المحاضرة الرابعة في مادة الكيمياء الصيدلانية العضوية للفصل الدراسي الثاني. اليوم راح نتكلم عن drugs acting on structural proteins. And this is going to be Lecture 4, Part 1. All right. Not many structural proteins act as drug targets. Okay. You don't see a lot of structural proteins that are targeted by drugs, except some antiviral structural proteins, but we are not talking antiviral here. So we are talking about anti-cancer or anti-cancer. The exception from that is the tubulin, which is a structural protein that is crucial for cell division. Okay, tubulin is made up of two separate proteins. Some of them called, some of the scientists call the those two separate proteins the alpha and the beta units or subunits. Okay, some of them call them unit one or unit two. We are going to call them the alpha and beta, okay? The protein act as a building block for microtubules. Tubulin acts as a building block for microtubules. And as the name implies, these are small tubules that are found or formed in the cytoplasm. The drugs that target tubulin can block this process either by binding to tubulin to prevent polymerization or by binding to microtubules to prevent depolymerization. Okay, why preventing polymerization or depolymerization is important? We can see here. Because tubulin, when they polymerize, they form the microtubules. You can see them here. While the microtubules, when they depolymerize, they form the tubulin. Let me do this one. Yeah. Okay. So tubulin polymerization results in microtubules. Microtubules depolymerization results in tubulin. That is why drugs that inhibit either the polymerization or the depolymerization are important as we said earlier, anti-cancer or anti-neoplastic agents. All right. So first we are going to be talking about the agents which inhibit tubulin polymerization. Okay. I think you know these from your previous pharmacognosy courses. Okay, these are the vinca alkaloids, like the vinblastine, vincristine, vindicine, and vinorelbine. Okay, and as you can see here, these are relatively big molecules. All of these are natural products. These are extracted from plants, from the vinca. That's why it calls the vinca alkaloid. The only differences between these are in the R1, the X, and the R3 groups. These are the only differences between those analogs. Okay. The vinorelbine is different from the others by here, by this double bond. Okay, it doesn't have the hydroxyl group, that's one. Second, it has this double bond, the vincristine, vinblastine, and vindicine. These doesn't have the double bond. Also, it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 member ring while the other analogs has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 number ring, nine numbers ring. Okay, these are the differences, but all of them they act by combining, they combine to tubulin, so prevent the polymerization to microtubule. All right. Other natural products that are being found to inhibit tubulin polymerization, like the filamphocyte. Okay, you see the structure here. And the filamphocyte is also extracted from plant. It inhibits the microtubule formation. And the spongistatin. And as the name implies, this one is not extracted from plant. It was extracted from a sponge, from a marine marine organism. And you can see the structure. It has a macrocyclic structure. This is the big cycle. I think you can see it now. All right. As I said, this one was not extracted from a plant. It was extracted from a sponge. But it also found that it inhibits tubulin polymerization. And all of these are natural products. All right. Other agents which inhibit tubulin polymerization, as we discussed in our first lecture, the podophyllotoxins, and we talked about the etoposide and the tenoposide, and we said they act as intercalating agents. Well, the podophyllotoxin, okay, that have been isolated from plant sources, the podophyllotoxin doesn't act as intercalating agent. It acts as a tubulin polymerization inhibitor, okay? The podophyllotoxin belongs to a group of compounds called lignans, and I think you know what do you mean by lignans from your previous pharmacognosy courses. The extracts of these plants have been used for over 1,000 years to treat a variety of diseases, okay? And it has been recorded that the roots of the wild chervil were used as a treatment for cancer in 1942, if I'm not being mistaken. And it has been shown that these roots contains the deoxypodophyllotoxin. Okay? For structures, of course, for the podophyllotoxin and the analogs, you have to go back to our first lecture. The crude extract from the plant is known as the podophyllum, and it has been demonstrated that this crude extract has anti-cancer activities. The podophyllotoxin was isolated from this extract and was used as an anti-cancer agent. But unfortunately, its use had to be restricted because of it has severe side effects, and the activity of epipodophyllotoxin. If you can go back and look at these structures from lecture one, against tubulin polymerization is an order of magnitude lower, not higher, but lower than podophyllotoxin. And I think you know what do we mean by order of magnitude. When bulky sugar molecules are present, the activity is gone. We lose the activity. And examples on the analogs that has the bulky sugar, like the etoposide and the tenoposide. Why the activity lost? Because sugar moieties form bad steric interactions with tubulin, which prevents binding. So no binding, no inhibition for the polymerization. The podophyllotoxin forms a complex with tubulin and prevents the synthesis of microtubules. And that is how they exert their action. Other examples on the natural products that act as tubulin polymerization are the cryptophysins. You see from the structure here, the cryptophysin 1, when the R group, this R group is hydrogen, and the cryptophysin 52, when the R group is methyl. Okay. Examples also the mitensine, this one, which belongs to a group of compound that's called the mitensinol. Okay, you see there are some similarities in the structure between the cryptophysin and the mitensine. Both of them have macro ring, as you can see here. Let me point those out. This ring and this one here. These are other examples on natural products that inhibit the tubulin polymerization. All right. Combretastatin are other natural products that also inhibit tubulin polymerization. The combretastatin A4, where the R group is hydrogen, is the most active structure. Okay. The one important thing here is that is the orientation of the two aromatic rings, this, or the conformation of the double bond. That is important for activity, okay? Which means this conformation, the cis conformation, is the active inhibitor, okay? If you have the trans conformation, where the R group will go on the other way, the trans will be like that. This will go here, and the group will be like that. So this group will go there. All right. So this one is going to be inactive. Okay. Also, one more important thing about the combretastatin, that it is selectively inhibit the blood supply to tumor and prevent angiogenesis. Okay, the combretastatin product, where the R group is phosphate, is now undergoing clinical trial, because this one, the phosphate product, has more solubility. And thank you very much for your listening, and we will continue with the second part.